Alola, Pokemon fans and gamers alike, it's your boy, the Edgemaster, with the Dirty Boy Swag. With the last part of my second day in the Galar Beginnings Online Competitions. So, let's get this started. I got like three more battles to complete. At least I think it's three more. If it tells me I have more battles, then I think it like reset on me. And that'd be really bad. Because that means I still have to participate later. Alright. Here comes our first challenger. What do you got? Ooh, man, he already has that prankster. Oh man, I really don't like that. It's not bad though. I think I start off with Duraludon. And then depending on what he has next, I'll probably bring in Raichu. It's probably the only thing that can take out that Barracuda. And my Raichu does have some pretty decent coverage. And then I feel like Drapion might also be a good one here, but I'm not entirely sure. But I could also go with Indeedee. Okay, so I'll go Duraludon, Raichu. No. Yeah. Okay. Toots. GLHF Toots. What is this? Togekiss. All right. I thought it might be something like this. Let's see if we can take it out. Unless he switches. Or he can trade into Dynamax. Okay, that's cool too. He'll probably do something that raises his speed. So if I can take it out as soon as possible, that'd be great. Gonna be a really scary Pokemon. Max Starfall. Really fast. Ooh, I barely survived that. Yeah. That's pretty tanky. Okay, well, maybe Metal Burst would have been really good here too. If I knew how fast it was gonna be. That's okay. It's too late now. Goodbye, Rika! I guess I'm going back. I'm just gonna stay on this negative streak. Oh, it has max earth shape, so it's definitely really good speed now. Might be faster than my Raichu. I mean, DD, but he's not gonna do much. I guess I can max lightning here too. That's the only thing I can do. And it's probably faster now that I got a max airstream up, and especially it's definitely not choice now that I think about it. He did just use max starfall earlier and then max stone. I think if I okay, next time I get that to happen, I'll probably end up using metal first. But that's like a 50-50 case. Other one I challenged last time did use nasty plot. So that's another thing as well. There we go. Ooh, yeah, it's definitely a lot faster. I think his Dynamax is done this time around. So let's see how that goes. You know, now that I think about it, Electric Terrain, When Home comes out, I think Alolan Raichu is actually going to be pretty damn good. You can Dynamax itself, and then it'll be like one of those other, like the swift swim users, you know? But in this case, it's for the terrain. That's actually pretty good. I like that. I better go breed one. Alright. I think that was like, what, my second turn in Dynamax? So, depending what he has next, he might just KO the rest of my mods, so it's gonna suck. But, hey, what can you do? Like, it would be cool if I could, like, not Dynamax right now. Or if my Dynamax ran out, depending on what he sends out. If my stuff does no draining kiss, maybe I can survive a couple of hits. We'll see. We'll see what he does. I might be able to switch out. Might. Big might. Dragon Pulse. I definitely cannot switch out. Because even if I switch out to MDD, I don't know how much damage he might be doing. So it's probably going to outspeed me. So we'll try to see if we can at least damage it. Or it can use Phantom Force. I'm gonna see if that affects my MDD. Because I am a normal type. So let's see. Oh, it doesn't affect me, bruh. I'm sorry. I didn't mean for that to not affect. I'm gonna calm mine right now. I mean, this might be a big mistake, but let's see, he might even switch out. That or if he Phantom Forces again, which I doubt he will. Yeah, so I'm probably good here. Yeah, I'm good. Yeah. Okay, that's fine. I kind of saw that coming, so that's fine. I mean, I didn't see that coming, but I was expecting to, like, you know, maybe dying. Well, his Barrascoot is probably faster than Raichu, so let's go. What are its stats? Sorry, I know I shouldn't be like looking up stuff while I'm doing this, but I'm kinda interested. Like, I'm really, really interested in seeing what kind of stats it has. Like how like good is its special defense? 50. Speed is 136, so I think it definitely outspeeds my Raichu probably, for sure. Let's go for the Draining Kiss then. I mean, I probably should have just went for the Thunderbolt here, but... Oh look, it even knows Drill Run. Yeah, I'm definitely dead. Doesn't matter if you just Shukaberry Raichu, you're dead. So it's definitely faster. I mean, no point in causing static right now. He's gone. He's dead. Tell me. Alright, so that's one loss for this video. And I am continuing on my negative streak. Let's go. Two more rounds. Let's go. After this, I'm gonna get something to eat. Damn. Two more battles. Let's go. What the hell is that? Someone knocking on my door? Oh, too bad. Alright. Streets. His name is Streets. Bring my Lotic into here, but that's like literally like one of my only dragon colors. It also has a seismic. I think Hitmontop, maybe Drapion. No, not Drapion. The only thing that worries me is just Spiral Thorn. So I mean, I have Hitmontop for that, but guess I could chance Raichu, maybe? Or Milotic? Oh man, okay, him on top, Milotic, and Indeedee, I guess. Okay. Alright, let's go. Can't bring Raichu, the other Seismitoad. We look at fun streaks. Sorry, set the chart. Right there, the Seismitoad. Alright. Good thing I didn't bring stuff. Okay, let's fake out first. I don't know if he's gonna switch out. That's pretty tanky. I might end up using a Seismitoad too. I love water ground types. I just wanna know, like, what's a good one. I know Quagsire might be kind of funny to use. Oh, a Stealth Rock user! Use a Stealth Rock user! Okay, bulky Stealth Rock setter. Okay. Let's do this then. Hopefully it blows it away regardless if he switches out. I really don't have anything to go up against that side of the board, though. I really need, like, grass coverage. Some kind of grass coverage. Maybe I'll take out Combine the Light to do, like, Energy Ball or something. I think I can learn Energy Ball. Should be able to, right? I got something. Sorry, bro. No more Stealth Rocks. Bye-bye. Ooh, maxing out its attack. Well, I'm gonna constantly bulldoze it so I can lower its speed at least. I mean, it's already pretty slow, but it would be very nice to make it to slow down like this. I could also Dynamax for his Dynamax, and I could power myself. Let's do that. Let's do that. Alright, I usually don't do this on him on top, but let's do it. He did it on his, let's do it on mine. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Alright, hit him on top. Let's do this. He's probably gonna constantly do more damage to you hit him on top though, so I'm sorry. Look at that, look how tanky that thing is. And that was a crit too. Can't imagine like how much more, how much less damage I'd be doing. He already has like two power ups now too. But I guess I'll be there soon too. But he is kind of slow, so I don't know if he'll switch out on his, when his stuff goes away or not. For once I'm kind of glad to have Rapid Spin. This is probably like the only time where I think I've been able to use it. So yeah. Ooh, still alive. Oh, that was a crit too. Did you have anybody else in his party that uses like Swiss Swim or something? It's possible he has Swiss Swim. So he might be able to kill me next turn. That's probably why he used the water move now. He probably has Swift Swim. I wouldn't be surprised. So I'm gonna chance this and see. You know what? I called my him on top Beyblade. I feel like I should have called him Eddie. Or Gordo. You know? If anybody gets that reference, just type in the reference to that in the comment section below. Hopefully people know who that is. Let's see, I don't know what he would use. I could also I took out one mon, so let's see if I'm probably not faster than it, but yeah, for sure. Oh, if I survive that, that'd be hella funny. That'd be hella funny. Okay, let's see. In terms of special attack, who has more? 147 to 112. But Dragon Coast doesn't do that. Still in my luck. It is raining, so I don't know if that affects anything, honestly, but let's nice beam it and we'll see how it happens. Substitute. What's he gonna do? He's probably gonna go for a Dragon Dance. Yeah. So his attack lowered just a bit. He definitely can't use substitute there. And he's definitely faster than I am. So I'm gonna go with another ice beam here. I could also switch out, but I give him props for using that sword. I love that sword. Not my favorite dragon type still yet, but I love them. I love them all the same. I especially love the shiny form. I have one myself. Sandaconda. Let's see, I don't know what he can do here. It might be faster than me as well. So I could also... try to recover here, and then we'll see how that goes. I'll find out if I'm faster than or not either, too, so... Okay, I'm definitely faster. I really can't use my MDD here. It's not gonna do anything. Drill. And I want it. Ooh, that was a crit, too. Okay, I know I'm faster than him now. I'm gonna go for one more recover and see how much damage you can actually do with that drill run. Still in range. Might crit. He really crit there. I'm gonna go for a third recover. I know I'm stalling here, but I just wanna see what I can do. I really wanna see how much damage I can actually pull off doing this one. Body press. I think I can recover again. And then on the next turn, I'll use a scald. Regardless of what, how much damage he does to me. Because if I can just weaken it enough to get my MDD to like kill it, that'd be fine. Ooh, that was a crit. I think he crit with that too. Could have killed it. Oh, I got a crit on him too. All right, crit back at you, bruh. And that is one win for this episode. Surprising. Alright, one more battle to go. I want to find out if I'll actually let me join in. Alright, let's go. One more battle for today. Hopefully. Because if it says I can do more battles, and like I said, I kind of just screwed up on the day portion. Because it's UTC time. That's like 2 o'clock in the afternoon. So it shouldn't be a full day yet, if anything, after this battle. Okay, what you got? Let's see. He's got a Swiss. He's got Seismitoad. Oh, man. Raichu would be nice to have here. Because depending on how this guy does his stuff, I don't know what to go for. Here. I want to bring in Didi again. But... Decisions. I'll go with him on top. It's the last battle for the episode. And we really can't go wrong with the log. Alright. Let's go. This guy can either start off with the Delibird. Not Delibird. Pelipper. And start off with Drizzle. I think he can probably U-turn out of here to bring out the Seismitoad. I feel like that's what he might do. So if the Pelipper comes out first. Pelipper is coming out. He might have Focus Sash as well. So if he's gonna U-turn here, I can at least fake him out. So that if he does have a Focus Sash, I can probably kill him on one. Not kill him, but I can probably, you know, prevent his Focus Sash from activating the next time I go up against it. He could also use Hurricane here and kill my enemy. Oh, well, next turn. My bad. Okay, so if he's switching out, though, I don't know what would be the best thing to switch into, but let's try. He'll probably U-turn, and then he'll switch out into Seismitoad. Yeah, he's using U-turn. But now that my Milotic's out, he might not switch into Seismitoad. He'll probably switch into something else. But his Seismitoad should be pretty fast. So if it has Swift Swim, Rotom. I think he can use Volt Switch though, so this is going to be a problem here. Let's see, I could protect here. Let's see what he does. I'll protect here first. But my skull should do quite a bit of damage. Especially with the Rain. Nasty play. Okay, he went Dynamax here. So you know what? I'll Dynamax first. Let's go. Depending on him too, he might also have a weakness policy. So his max lightning, after hitting him with this pole, will probably do a crap load of damage. So that's going to suck. Like big time. Oh no, he's still nasty plotting. Oh. But it's definitely faster. But it's dead. Okay. That works. I mean, that's one turn of my Dynamax gone though. So that's scary. That's really scary. Seismitoad. See, I knew it. Seismitoad. He'll probably Dynamax here too. So I'll just max Geyser again. He'll probably max Geyser back. Oh, here's Power Whip! We can learn Power Whip! Yo, that's cool. The plugged in your special defense though, bro. I mean, I'm probably gonna die to that pop, but what I could do is also switch out. I should have used Max Hailstone first. Power Whip did quite a bit of damage. I could switch out there. But he could Dynamax again as well. Do I chance this? The stuff is already pretty low on HP. I can switch to Duralla. Switch out. I wouldn't want to switch out here, but let's do it. I haven't switched out like a Dynamax Pokemon before, so at least I don't think I have. So this is gonna be something different. I'll lower his attack at the same time. Probably gonna use Power Whip. Ooh, I even avoided the attack. Nice. The first thing here, I don't think Fake Out works anymore. But let's go for a close combat. Good switch. What else does he have? I don't know what his third mon is. Switch up to the Rattata. Now you'll see my third mon. Oh wait, no! We know where his third mon is! We took out his Rodan Heat! Oh, I totally forgot about that. Yo, he used a Master Ball to catch this Pelipper. Why? Did you like, mistake for it or something? It's not even shiny. Max Airstreak. His speed is raising. I don't know how to play this. So I'm gonna assume it's faster than me. Oh, the rain did stop though. So rain's not coming back up yet. Press use a water type, and it's not gonna do much damage. Whatever. Draco Meteor, let's go. See how much damage we can do. Come on. Come on, Draco Meteor. But if it's still raining, Seismitoad is still going to be pretty damn scary. But there's a lot of speed in there. Pink tankies, help. We're still tanking in like a mile. I could switch into my Lotic right now. Might be a bad decision, but I think I can tank its water. It'll probably use the next geyser again. He's not scared. Okay, I'll try to recover here. It's probably faster and will do damage. He could even U-turn again. Or he can use Roost. Another flying type with Roost. I really hate this move after going up against that Corviknight now. Hella of annoying. Definitely say that for sure. Hell, I wouldn't even mind just using Scald right now, but we have a bunch of Ice Beams, so let's do Ice Beam. Maybe we'll have a chance to freeze it. That'd be great, just like that last match. Hurricane never misses. But I'm also kind of special. So. for another ice beam. Now that we know his hurricane doesn't do too much. Oh, he's gonna scald me too. Hey, he has the right idea though. Because I could get burnt. But I'm going for the freeze here. That's what I'm betting. I'm betting on the freeze. Probably roost. No, he's gonna scald. He knows he's faster. I don't know if they ever have the stab move here. Maybe not. No, it's not very effective. He's probably gonna roost here. Yeah, okay. That was to be expected. Another stall game for the last game. Oh, jeez. Okay. I didn't need too much damage. Oh, I see. He used Roost, so he loses the flying typing. Okay. You know what? My turn to scald. Let's try. Maybe I'll get luck. I'll get more lucky on burn. Let's see. If I don't get burned first. Yeah, I got that first. Oh, my spell does play much. But the rain has stopped. So he should have his ice type, yeah, his flying type thing back up again. So what I could do is try to recover here. I wanna freeze this guy. He'll probably roost here. He's gonna play safe, and he's definitely gonna roost. Or he can use it. That works as well. Seismic. I use Ice Beam, right? So it should do normal damage to it. But his Seismic Tub is also almost dead. He probably thought I was gonna kill. Seismic Tilt can't be that fast, can it? I don't know, let's find out. We'll find out. I'm trying to switch out again. Yeah, like, you turn my team to which I don't think he'll do, especially now that he got drizzled back up. You could go for another hurricane and try to kill me, but I don't know if he wants to play safe or not. Okay, we'll go for another ice beam. That beats freaking stall teams. Oh, that's it. Hey, there we go. But his stuff has switched in though. Oh yeah, it does. He'll probably power with the game. Can I still win this? How much HP is the seismic? Like one? Oh. You know what? I could probably be a dick here. I can probably be a dick on the next turn. Let's see. Either I win this now, or I win this next turn. Okay, so I can either be a dick here, or I can just try. You know what? I'm gonna try. It's turn number one. If he doesn't use protect first, get you got quick. I didn't mean to fake you out like that, but it was a way to win. I'm sorry. GG though. GG Peiku, or however you pronounce your name. I'm sorry if I'm butchering. All right. And I am at 15 and 15. Wow, that's, let's see if I can continue battling. It's not gonna let me. Yep, okay. Good. So, I'm at 15 wins and 15 losses. I'm literally back at like 0-0. Anyways, thanks for watching, guys. Hit that like button if you haven't already. Subscribe if you haven't already. That'd be greatly appreciated. You know, share this video with a friend, man. I mean, like, I may not be the best, like, battler, but this is getting kind of fun for me. Like I said earlier before, I usually tilt on, like, you know, after I get a few losses and everything, but somehow or another, I'm having quite a bit of fun. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, this was your boy, the Edgemaster with the Dirty Boy Swag, GoodGamerGlen's. And I'll catch you guys in the next episode. Alola.